I am Article 15. I ensure social equality and equal access to public areas. I come with 5 claws that can really give you hard times.
Well, I guess these are not claws. These are claws.
Yeah, they work the same. Now take this. I hand you over to my first clause. Hey state, never discriminate against citizens. Remember, never discriminate against citizens only on the grounds of religion, race, sex, caste or place of birth. But yes, you can discriminate on the other grounds like age, physical strength, etc.
Whoa, stop. And please explain this with example.
Are you serious? Can't you even understand simple legal English? Have you gone around the country? Now focus. For example, previously in India, retirement age for male in-flight crew was 58. Air hostesses were required to retire at 35 or on marriage or on their first pregnancy, whichever occurred earlier. Now this is discrimination based on not only on sex but other grounds such as age and other circumstances. And as per law of the land, this is valid. Similarly, in health sectors, female nurses are preferred. In armed forces, males are preferred. This may not sound gender equal, but it is what it is. Oh, I see. Got it. The state can discriminate citizens on other grounds apart from race, sex, place of birth, etc. Oh, that's not it. I am clause 2 and you both, state and individuals, you guys shall not prohibit citizens' access to public places. No citizen shall be discriminated against in having access to public places such as restaurants, hotels, places of entertainment, public well, tanks, roads, place of worship on grounds only of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth or any of them. I am similar to the first clause, but I am available against both state and individual. Yes, against individual too. And I grant all citizens equal access to public places. Oh, you guys are too restrictive. I cannot function this way. Hold on to that. No need to worry. We all are not that bad. Though my older brothers restricted you, I empower you. I empower you, the state, to make special provisions for welfare of women and children because they are vulnerable and they need protection. I and clause 4 and 5, we speak for the equal protection of law. Because of me, the seats are reserved in local self bodies and in parliament for women. Oh, that's relief and positive. Yeah, I am positive too, like clause 3. I too empower you to make special provisions for the advancement of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes or any socially and educationally backward class of citizens. Oh, works for me. Wait for me. I am clause 5. I am much younger. I was born in 2005. My mother is 93rd Constitutional Amendment Act. I too empower you like clause 3 and 4. You state can make special provisions by law for advancement of any socially and educationally backward classes of citizens. Why? For admission to educational institutions, including a private institution, aided or unaided by the state. But remember this, minority educational institutions referred to in clause 1 of Article 30, that is, like institutions such as madrasas are exempted from me. I am the last one. I am clause 6 of Article 15 and I am the latest one. I empower states to make special provisions for advancement of any economically weaker section, EWS, other than those mentioned in clauses 4 and 5. And to make a special provisions on their admission to educational institutions, including aided or unaided private ones. This will be in addition to existing reservation and subject to a maximum of 10% of total seats in each category.
similar to clause 5, minority run institutions such as madrasas are exempted.
Perfect. Thank you.
So, Article 15 secures the citizens from every sort of discrimination by the state on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex or place of birth or any of them. However, I do not prevent the state from making any affirmative actions like special provisions for women or children. Also, my provisions allow the state to extend special provisions for socially and economically backward classes for their advancement. Moreover, my provisions applies to the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes as well. So this is how I ensure social equality and equal access to public areas for my citizens. And these were my six clauses. My first clause bites and rest empowers the state.